Good evening, everyone. He's a well-known name on the force and in the community.
Des Moines Police Lieutenant Joe Gonzalez is in stable condition tonight at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Mark Soucek has the latest.
Well, surgeons spent 4 hours today attempting to stabilize bone fragments from 6 of Lieutenant Gonzalez's 13 ribs that were shattered in the accident. He was injured off duty working security at an event at the World Food Prize building downtown a couple weeks ago when he was crushed between a truck and a wall. No one knows when Gonzalez will be back in Des Moines, but every day he is gone, he is missed, especially by the Hispanic community.
I think it's really hard for him to be laying flat on that bed right now because he knows that there's so much work to be done.
Sergeant Vince Valdez has watched his friend and fellow officer rise to become the highest-ranking Hispanic in the history of the Des Moines Police Department. One community leader calls Joe Gonzalez the most visible male role model for young Hispanics in the city. Over 10 years ago, Gonzalez spearheaded the Hispanic outreach program, working to build trust with young men and women especially.
They're searching for that American dream. They're searching for something to better themselves with.
Gonzalez himself came to America with his family in the late 50s and was greeted by Mary Campos, who helped steer Gonzalez into the police academy as an 18-year-old in 1971.
He loves being a policeman. And he's the kind of guy that can talk to everybody.
She says for over 40 years, Gonzalez has worked tirelessly with immigrants in Des Moines who come from countries where police are often not trusted.
Joe was there all the time to assure them that just because they talked to a law officer didn't mean that something bad was going to happen.
Joe, thank you very much for everything you've done.
In 2008, Gonzalez was honored for his dedication to helping crime victims. In 2003, he was Rotary Club's Officer of the Year. He also volunteered after 9/11 in New York City, providing support to the iron workers, removing steel at Ground Zero.
As they were doing that, every once in a while they would find some bodies, or some remains, I should say. When they did, then they would have to stop and they would have this little ceremony.
But it's his tireless outreach every day on Des Moines city streets that will be his legacy.
He feels that he needs to keep that energy up, and that's why he's so visible in the community, because he's everywhere.
Lieutenant Gonzalez's brother told me tonight that surgeons this afternoon drained 1.5 liters of blood trapped in his chest to give his lungs more room to inflate. He is in stable condition tonight and recovering on a ventilator, Kevin.
Mark, incredible news. Does anyone know if Lieutenant Gonzalez intends to come back and continue working after all of this?
Well, he is 60 years old. That's an age when a lot of officers have retired, but his good friend today, Sergeant Valdez, told me despite all the injuries, he really wouldn't be surprised at all if he tried to come back.
Mark Soucek, thank you very much.